Bitrise build is defined by its workflows. A workflow consists of a sequence of steps. In today's video, we will be discussing how you can create, chain, and rearrange workflows on our website. We have a demo iOS app at hand, which we'll use to create a workflow chain. Our use case is simple. We'd like to run a testing build of this iOS app. We'll do a git clone, install missing dependencies, then run UI and unit tests, and finally, deploy the test resource to bitrise.io and send a Slack message to team members. We'll be arranging these in separate workflows and show you how to play around with them in a chain setup. More about that later. Okay, let's get started. Go to your builds page and click the workflow tab. Click the workflow plus button to create a new workflow. It can be based off of another workflow, which means all of its steps will be copied into this new workflow. Or you can also select the based and an empty workflow option. We will go with that today. Give it a name. If your workflow should be a reusable utility workflow, which is the case in this video, add an underscore before its name. Click done. Keep creating new workflows until you have all the workflows needed for your chain. We are creating a UI and a unit test workflow and two utility workflows, one called deploy and one called notify. Let's open the workflow menu and have a look at all the workflows available. But wait a second, what if you realized you typed the wrong name just now and you'd like to change it? You can rename a workflow by clicking the button next to the workflow's name in the drop-down menu, as you've just done with the setup utility workflow. Do not forget to save the change by clicking the tick. Okay, now that we're done with this, let's arrange our workflows in a chain. This means that the workflows in question will run after one another during your build. Add a workflow before or after another one. In today's example, we're selecting the setup utility workflow which will be followed by all the other workflows. Click the Add Workflow After button and select the workflow that should come after the setup one. Hit Done. Keep adding workflows to create a chain setup. You can see we've just finished organizing our workflows in a chain. But what if you decide to rearrange the order? In this case, you can click the Rearrange button and simply drag and drop a workflow before or after another one. Hit Done. You could have added steps to your individual workflows before as well, but we're going to take care of it now. We're adding the steps as discussed in the use cases. And finally, if you decide to remove a workflow from the chain, you can select the workflow's name from the workflow menu and click Delete Workflow. Click Save. And there you have it. You've just witnessed how to chain workflows together. To start a build, let's go back to your builds page and click Start Schedule a Build. We've mentioned utility workflows in this tutorial many times. If you'd like to find out more about them, have a look at our Dev Center article. There's a step-by-step guide on how to create multiple white label app versions using chain workflows as well. Links are in the message box below. Give us a thumbs up if you liked this video and feel free to give us some feedback in the comments.